morning, class.
Good morning, sir.
Okay, thank you. How are you today?
Fine, sir.
And how about you, sir?
I'm doing okay.
Fine, thank you. And you?
I'm doing okay too, Risma. Thank you. So, are you ready to learn today?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Now, of course. I can see your face is still glimmering. So yeah, we are going to start the lesson today. Before we start, let's say a prayer. Maybe Nurul Janata, can you lead a prayer for us?
Okay, sure. Of course. Okay, friends. Before we start the lesson, let's pray together. Start. Finish.
Okay, thank you, Nurul. That is wonderful prayer. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the things around us. So I'm going to ask you a question. Do you know what tool do you use to sit? Can anybody answer me?
Chair.
Yeah, good, Budi. So chair is one of the things that we can find around us. So our main topic today is about the thing that you can find around us. And why do we have to learn this? Okay, why do we have to learn this? Because any things or items around us serve a purpose. For example, a chair, which is a tool that you use to sit, and also maybe the table or pen or book. Every item, everything serve a purpose for our life. Okay, do you got it?
No.
No.
Jadi masing-masing benda yang diciptakan atau yang dibuat mempunyai fungsinya dan kegunaannya masing-masing. Got it?
Oh, I see.
That is why we have to learn about the things around us. Okay?
Okay.
So let me share screen and show you our material for today. Can you see it?
Yes.
So
yes, I can. Ada kursi ya, Pak, ya?
Yeah, good, Budi. You can see chair, you can see table. So first, the chapter 4 is about the things around us. Our main purpose of the lesson is at the end of the lesson, you have to able to analyze the things around us, evaluate the number and function of things around us, create semantic mapping. This will be explained later, and also present the semantic mapping in front of the class. Okay, jadi pada akhir pembelajaran, kalian diharapkan bisa melihat, menganalisis benda-benda di sekitar kalian. Gunanya untuk apa? Sebagai contoh. Next, evaluate. Mengevaluasi berapa jumlahnya, bagaimana kualitasnya, umpamanya. Terus, next, it is about creating semantic mapping. I will explain this later, okay? And then you have to present the semantic mapping in front of the class. Okay, do you got it?
Okay.
Little bit.
Yeah. Okay. Next, let's move to, I will show you an image, okay? You can tell how many image do you recognize? Can you see a map?
No.
Yes.
Irdiana, where is the map located? Di mana tempatnya map kira-kira?
Oh, on the wall.
Okay, good. You can see map here. It's on the wall.
Okay.
What about Sri?
Pintar.
Where is the ruler? Can you see the ruler?
Tidak, Pak. Tidak.
Yeah.
On the table.
Okay,
on the,
good. This on one is the ruler. Table. Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
What about Linda? Can you see the blackboard?
Oh, of course.
Yes, of course.
It is.
Okay, it is in front of the class. So all of the things around us that you probably also have in your school. So these are main things that usually there in the classroom. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Let's move to. Does anyone have a question about the picture? Maybe Sylvia? No?
No.
Okay.
No idea.
Linda, Pak, Walinda, Walinda.
Ya, Linda, please.
Pak, itu saya tidak tahu apa ya, Pak, gambar apa di samping blackboard?
Okay. Di samping blackboard, you can see the number. Here is the help of the image. So,
kalender ya, Pak.
Ada duster and chalk. Oh. Kenapa? Iya, Budi, silakan.
Itu yang di sebelah kanan itu apa, Pak?
Kalender. Which one?
Ya.
What number?
17.
Number 17 is the calendar. It is a calendar. Do you know what calendar is?
Oh ya ya ya, kalender
okay,
ya.
Okay, good.
Kalender, kalender Pak Guru.
Ya, yeah, good.
Kalender yang biasa di dinding itu, Pak, kan? Ya, kalender yang di dinding, Pak.
Good, nice one. That is the calendar that usually we use to see the date. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, this one is the next items that you usually put in your bag. For example, colored pencils. Or pencil, or pen, or maybe a rubber, ruler. You must have seen all the things in this image, right? Kalian pasti sudah pernah melihat semua benda-benda di gambar ini, kan?
Sudah, Pak.
Ya, ya. Punya semua itu, Pak. Punya semua.
Punya gunting. Punya gunting.
Hari hampir tiap hari lihatnya, Pak.
Okay, good. Fitri, which one do you rarely see?
Oh, enggak kebaca tulisannya.
Enggak tahu bahasa Inggris saya, Pak.
Oke, okay, yang mana yang jarang dilihat?
Betul.
Kenapa, Pak?
Yang mana yang jarang dilihat dari gambar?
Jarang.
Jarang dilihat.
Itu tuh, pencil case-nya bagus ya, unik kayaknya, Pak.
Oke, okay, pencil case. Ya, yeah, this one is kind of unique. Ya. Yeah.
Banyak sekali.
Saya tidak punya, Pak. Yang itu kayaknya mahal, Pak, belinya.
Oh, okay, it's okay. You can use a regular pencil case that you have. It is just an example or an image of the things around you. Okay?
Pencil case.
Okay. Now let's move to a more cognitive material. Okay? So when you, I will explain about the article. So article is to define a noun. Sebagai contoh, kalau dalam bahasa Indonesia, kalian bisa mengucapkan a book yang berarti sebuah buku. So, what is the difference between a and an? Well, we can see from the example that a before nouns which begin with consonant sounds. Jadi a digunakan kepada kata dalam bahasa Inggris yang dimulai dengan suara konsonan. For example, book. Book starts with consonant b. Book. Another example is flower, for example. Jadi kata flower dimulai dengan consonant f. Flower. Okay? Do you got it?
Okay.
Konsonan itu apa, Pak?
Konsonan adalah suara huruf mati. Jadi dia dimulai dari K selain dari huruf vokal sebagai contoh. But let's see unicorn. Unicorn start with U. It is a vocal letters. However, akan tetapi unicorn dibaca dengan you. Dia jadi katanya dimulai dengan y atau y dan tidak dengan u. That's why we use a unicorn, not an unicorn.
Boleh okay? Tanya Pak Guru? Boleh
yes.
Tanya?
Silahkan Budi.
Berarti itu tergantung pengucapannya ya Pak Guru ya, bukan hurufnya ya?
Exactly, tepat sekali. Bergantung dari pengucapan, bukan huruf. Betul. Wih,
pintarnya, Budi.
Kita tidak tahu ucapinya berarti.
Budi, pintar sekali. Yeah.
That's why we have to learn.
Okay? Cerdas, Fitri.
Good, Budi. Really good question. Give applause to Budi. Okay, nice. Now, next example is about N. N, you can use N before nouns which begin with vocal sounds. Vocal sounds, jadi A, E, U, E, O, or A, I, U, E, and O. For example, an ant. Jadi ant adalah semut. Jadi seekor semut, umpamanya. An elephant. Jadi elephant starts dengan a, elephant. Makanya menggunakan an elephant. What about honor or our? Our?
Ya Pak Guru, kok itu yeah. Pakai an dia?
Yeah. Our-nya tuh. Jadi meskipun dia menggunakan letter atau huruf yang konsonan, tapi pada saat dia diucapkan, dia dimulai dengan our. Jadi hanya itu hampir tidak terbaca atau terucapkan sama sekali. Do you got it?
Ya, ya, Pak Guru.
Okay.
Sedikit-sedikit, Pak.
Okay, nice. Next, we talk about the. The is for definite nouns, which means that kita menggunakan the untuk sesuatu yang sudah jelas. Mungkin masih kurang jelas ya penjelasannya. Let's move to the next one. Here it is.
Wih, maybe, ada kue nih.
Wih, cowok ganteng nih kayaknya nih.
Maybe Muhammad Al-Farabi can read the first sentence here.
Okay, baik, Pak. I will try.
Okay.
Kalau yang laki-laki, I have a tart cake. Okay. The cake is sweet.
Okay, good. Give a applause to Al-Farabi.
Prim.
Okay, nice.
Tapi benar.
I have a tart cake. Jadi saya memiliki sebuah kue tart.
Tart. Ulang tahun, yeah. Pak, ya.
Ya, good. Saya mau. Well, here is the use of the menandakan bahwa cake yang dimaksud adalah kue yang ini, kue ulang tahun. Kue ulang
tahun.
Tahun,
Pak. Kue ulang tahun, Pak.
Ya. Jadi the di sini menandakan bahwa kuenya adalah kue yang ini, kue ulang tahun, bukan kue jenis lain.
Kue jenis lain.
Okay, next Sylvia, can you read these sentences?
Ya, Pak, dicoba.
Okay.
I have a keychain. The keychain is so nice.
Okay, good. Give a plus to Sylvia.
Pak Guru, tanya. Boleh tanya, Pak Guru?
Ya, silahkan, Budi.
Apa itu keychain, Pak?
Keychain, kanan, ya? Maksudnya adalah gantungan kunci.
Wah, kira-kira.
Okay. Bacanya ya. Gimana, Pak, tadi yang benar, ya?
Cara bacanya... Kita dengarkan bersama. I have a keychain.
I have a
keychain.
I have a keychain.
Okay, good.
I have
a keychain. The keychain is so nice.
The keychain is so nice.
The keychain is so nice.
Okay, go.
So nice.
Yeah. So nice.
So nice itu sosis Pak Guru.
Okay. Now let's pay attention to the material. Okay. Now here is a. A berarti dia memiliki sebuah gantungan kunci.
Gantungan kunci.
Nah, the keychain gantungan kunci yang dia miliki sangat Bagus.
Bagus ya.
Lanyap.
Ya, jadi gantungan kunci ya, yang dia enak. Maksud bagus. Adalah gantungan kunci miliknya, bukan milik orang lain. Okay, let's move to the next material. Now, singular and plural.
Orang lain.
Singular means satu saja atau tunggal. Sedangkan plural berarti jamak atau lebih dari satu. So, in English,
jamak.
Good. If you would like to say something more than one or plural, you can just add s or es at the end of the noun. Okay? So, for example, many nouns end in s and many other end in es. If they end in s, x, ch, or sh. Jadi apabila sebuah kata atau noun berakhir dengan s, x, ch, and sh, mereka menggunakan es. Atau konsonan yang berakhir dengan y, maka mereka menggunakan tambahan i dan es. Okay, for example, you can see from the example. So, cup dalam bentuk satu atau tunggal, plural, adalah cups. And then, next, baby. Baby berarti satu bayi, tapi dia berakhir dengan Y. Apabila katanya berakhir dengan Y, maka ditambahkan IES. Jadi, sorry, IES. Jadi, babies. Menandakan bahwa banyak bayi. Good. And then you can see the another example. For example, leaf. Do you know what leaf mean? Maybe Nunet? Nunet?
Saya Pak.
Ya. Yeah. Apa artinya
leaf? Leaf meninggalkan Pak Guru.
Leaf itu daun ya Pak.
Betul sekali. Good, really good. Give applause to Nunan.
Pintar sekali.
So, guru, apa bedanya leaf meninggalkan?
Ya, okay, good. Leaf meninggalkan dengan leaves yang ini adalah leaves dalam bentuk plural atau jamaknya dari daun. Sedangkan leaf meninggalkan dia merupakan kata kerja. Jadi di sini daun merupakan kata benda yang bentuk pluralnya adalah leaves, sedangkan leaf yang Al-Farabi maksud adalah kata kerja yang berarti meninggalkan. Okay? Do you have any questions?
I got it.
Okay. Do you have any question again? Maybe another? Okay. That is our main topic for.
Pak Guru, saya masih belum mengerti, Pak Guru.
Which one do you not still understand, Al-Farabi?
Yang IES, Pak Guru. Kenapa pakai IES tadi?
Okay, okay, good. Good question from Al-Farabi. Why we use I, E, dan S di akhir sebuah kata? Kita menggunakan IES apabila kata benda tersebut berakhir dengan konsonan Y. Maka kita menambahkan IES di akhir kata tersebut. Sebagai contoh, baby or theory. So it turns into babies and theory turns into theories. Okay? So it implies that the plural form of the word. Okay, do you got it, Al-Farabi?
Got it, sir. Got it.
Okay, nice.
Izin tanya, Pak. Izin tanya.
Ya, silahkan, Sylvia.
Kalau strawberry itu pakai ES atau IES, Pak?
Okay, strawberry berakhir dengan huruf apa katanya? Kalau boleh tanya, Sylvia.
Huruf Y, Pak.
Betul sekali. Apabila berakhir dengan huruf Y, maka kita menambahkan bentuk plural yang mana? Adalah IES. Jadi strawberries. Makanya dia ditambahkan IES. Do you got it, Sylvia?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Pak, bertanya.
Okay, silahkan Linda.
Pak, itu di bawah baby urutan ketiga itu kok tulisannya huruf F-nya berubah Pak jadi P, Pak.
Betul sekali. Dia berubah apabila lihat penjelasan. Oke. Jika noun atau kata kerja berakhir dengan F atau F dan E, maka dia berubah menjadi V. Jadi F berubah menjadi V dan menambahkan IS di belakangnya. Contohnya kata live ini, karena dia berakhir dengan huruf F, that is why it changed to V plus IS. Do you got it, Linda?
Oh
ya,
mengerti Pak
sekarang. Okay, nice. That is a good question from all of you, and I really appreciate it. Okay, now I would like to divide you into three groups. Maybe I'll read it just right away. Sylvia, Nunet, and Muhammad Al-Farabi is group one. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Rusma, Linda, and Fitri, group two. Okay.
Okay, Pak. Okay.
Alright.
Okay, and then Budi, Irdiana, Nurul, and Sri is group three. Okay.
Okay, sure.
Now I would like to share a student sheet. You have to do it with your own teams, okay? You have to do the student sheets with your group. Okay, you can work on it right now. Okay, good. You have done the student sheet. Let's move to the next material, which is about semantic mapping. Can you see the image?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? No?
No, clear, sir. No.
Clear, very clear.
Clear, lumayan, Pak.
Okay.
Okay. So this one.
Ada yang school.
Good. So this one is an example of semantic mapping about school. So you can map the school into some categories. For example, facilities, subjects, class, places, and people. So you can see facilities have blackboard, fan, projector, and computer. Subjects, do you know what subjects mean? Maybe Sri?
Kenapa?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what is a subject? What is your opinion about subject?
Subject is
pelaku.
Okay.
Mata pelajaran.
Okay, good, Sri. But Sylvia also correct. Subjects can be refers to as pelaku if it's in the sentence. Okay. So in this case,
Irdiana Pak yang jawab.
I'm really sorry. Yeah, Indiana. Indiana also correct, okay? So in this case, Sri is correct. Subjects in this case is mata pelajaran. You can see Chinese, English, mathematics, visual arts. And then school also have places. What is places, Nurul?
Places, it means tempat in Indonesia.
Okay, good, Nurul. So school also have tempat, which includes classroom, hall, library, or canteen. And then people. School also have people. What is people, Rusma? Okay.
Rusma lagi main HP, Pak Guru.
Orang.
Rusma main HP, Pak Guru.
Rusma online, Pak.
Jadi perhatikan dulu ya kalau gurunya menjelaskan karena kita
saling sharing. Lagi baku ya dengan pacarnya itu, Pak.
Oh ya.
Lihat jam jadi, terus jam istirahat Pak.
Jadi people adalah orang-orang. Jadi sekolah juga mempunyai orang-orang. Principal, teacher, janitor. Do you know what janitor means? Maybe Linda?
Tidak tahu Pak. Kayaknya tukang bersih-bersih Pak kayaknya.
Betul sekali. Jadi janitor adalah yang membersihkan biasanya lingkungan dari Sekolah.
Sekolah.
So this is one example of semantic mapping that you can create with your group. Okay? So ya, you can maybe specifically mention about the facilities. For example, laboratory or library. So in library, maybe you have books. You can differentiate the types of books. For example, buku pelajaran atau mungkin buku cerita dan lain sebagainya. Do you got it?
Okay, ya, nice. Pak.
Now I will.
Apa susah?
It's okay. I will guide you throughout the learning process. Okay. Now I will play you a video about how to create semantic mapping based on your mind. Okay.
Ya Pak.
Okay, that is the video of how to create a semantic map from the things around us. For you can see from the video that the video tries to explain about car. So car has several aspects. For example, fuel, tire, driver, and window. So this one is the type of semantic map that you can create based on your own understanding about the things around you. As I said before, jadi seperti yang saya katakan sebelumnya, bahwa kalian dapat membuat semantic mapping berdasarkan suatu fasilitas yang ada di sekolah, seperti contohnya tadi library, perpustakaan, atau laboratory, or maybe teacher's room, dan kalian bisa menyebutkan apa-apa saja yang ada di dalam fasilitas sekolah tersebut. Sebagai contoh, di laboratorium mungkin mempunyai teleskop. Di perpustakaan mungkin mempunyai rak buku. Di ruang guru mungkin mempunyai kipas angin sebagai contoh. Do you got it?
Pak Jim bertanya.
Yes, please Sylvia.
Kalau bikin yang mapping-nya untuk benda di rumah boleh, Pak?
We still in the material about the things around you at school. We will get into that in the next meeting, okay? In the next lesson.
Bye, Pak.
Okay, nice question, Sylvia. Next, so you have to do it with your own group, okay?
Okay.
You have to
create...
Yes, Rusma.
I have a question.
Okay.
Berapa jumlah benda yang harus disebutkan?
So you can mention 10 to 20 things about the facilities, for example. It's up to your group. Jadi kalian bisa menyebutkan 10 sampai 20 benda. Okay, good question, Rusma.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Now, before you create your semantic mapping, I would like to remind you that semantic mapping-nya dibuat dengan menggunakan bahan daur ulang seperti kertas atau kardus yang sudah tidak terpakai. Jadi, kalian bisa memanfaatkan hal tersebut untuk membuat semantic mapping itu berdasarkan kemampuan dan kreativitas kalian. Tentunya dengan bimbingan Pak Guru. Oke?
Okay? Baik, Pak.
Ya. Next, your group job is to write the schedule of your project. Jadi kalian bisa melihat contoh schedule atau jadwal dari rencana kegiatan kalian. Jadi kalian bisa mencocokkan dengan contoh seperti ini. Oke?
Okay? Baik, Pak.
Oke. Okay. Now we have arrived at the end of our lesson. Maybe anyone can help me conclude the lesson today? Ada yang bisa bantu saya untuk menyimpulkan apa yang telah kita pelajari hari ini?
Al-Farabi, Pak. Al-Farabi.
Ya, silakan Al-Farabi.
Ya, Pak Guru. Jadi hari ini kita sudah belajar tentang things around us in the school.
Okay, good. Apalagi kira-kira? Nurul?
kita sudah belajar tentang apa ya Pak, benda-benda Pak.
Okay, good. So we have learned about the things around us at school. We have learned about an article and how to use it, and we can and we also learn about the singular and plural form of the things around you. Okay. Okay. Do you like the lesson so far? Apakah kalian menyukainya pembelajarannya sejauh
suka,
ini?
Pak.
Suka sekali Pak Guru.
Banyak gambar-gambar Pak. Saya suka lihat gambar-gambar.
Lain kali kita menggambar juga Pak Guru.
Iya, yeah, you can
Pak Guru bawa spidolnya, spidol yeah, warnanya.
Pak Guru yang siapkan spidolnya. Jadi yeah, kalian bisa menggambar semantik mapping yang kalian buat nanti. Oke?
Okay? Oke, okay, Pak.
Oh, ya.
Yeah. Pak Guru.
I'm glad that you pay a close attention to the lesson today, and also thank you very much for your participation. And we should close it with a pray too, okay? Maybe Linda, can you lead us with the closing prayer?
Okay, teman-teman, let's we pray together. Finish.
Okay, thank you, Linda. So I forgot one more thing. Next week, you have to create the semantic mapping. So you have to bring the materials, and we will do it, or we will work on it at school. Okay?
Bye, Pak.
Okay, I think that's all for today for our lesson. Thank you for your attention and participation. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good morning.
Waalaikumsalam.
Goodbye, sir.